say hi to my naked nails. So today we're going to be doing this nail art look using dry brushing technique. Please don't mind the nail polish stain around my middle fingernail because I clicked the pictures right away I finished the nail art look. At first I thought I would do this one because it turned out a lot prettier than the previous one, but didn't have enough video clips of it, so couldn't make a descriptive edit, so I got stuck with this one, which I think turned out quite well as well. So we can work with that. Okay, not all of my nails are completely naked because the pinky one still has some white nail polish stain on it, and I was feeling so lazy to wipe it off because we're not gonna need that in the video. Also, you can notice that not all of my fingers are of the same length because they keep breaking. And if you follow me on Instagram, then you would know how it broke. It was such a sad time for me. Whatever, move on. Now, start off by applying a clear base coat. You can totally avoid this step if you don't really change your nail polish regularly, which I do, so I need to keep my nails a bit more protected. So yeah. Now, after these are completely dry, apply your base color. I'm gonna be using 3 different base colors for this because I'm experimenting for you guys. Sacrifice. Duh. I'm gonna be using white for the index finger. I'm gonna be applying 2 coats so that I can get the opacity I want. Black for the middle finger because I'm not racist. And yellow for the ring finger. Yeah, because I'm not racist again. Now, dry brushing is a very good option for the people who don't want to draw a lot of stuff on their nails but still want some nail art on their nails. And for the people who love colors or love abstract stuff and all. Okay, now after the base colors are completely dry, then apply the second step because otherwise the colors will mix up and make a very bad mess. Now I'm gonna be taking all of my dried up polishes because that's a pretty good option for recycling these. You can see this is from Maybelline and I don't really like its consistency. It is dried up. Now take the brush and wipe off the nail polish it's got in a paper, white, black, yellow, whatever. And then take the brush and apply the leftover nail polish on your nails. I guess I was pretty descriptive about it. Okay, whatever. Now for the black one, you must remember to use bright colors because otherwise it will not really show itself on black. And for the yellow one, I tried to do a, you know, kind of similar toned colors, yellow, orange and red, which I think turned out really really pretty. You will see, or you've already seen in the thumbnail or at the beginning of the video. This is another dried up nail polish. You can also use normal nail polish, but this is like I'm cheap, so I use dried up. I recycle them and don't buy new ones. With dry brushing, you can just go crazy with any direction, any colors, anything. It saves a lot of time for a lot of people and it looks extremely pretty. You can use it as a background and do different things over it, which I'm gonna do at the end of the video. Yeah, it's like a hack for the people who are cheap like me, who don't want to buy new nail polish and don't want to throw their old dried up nail polish away. So yeah, life hack. You're welcome. Just go crazy with colors and directions as I am going. As you can see, for the yellow one, I'm only using red, orange, these kind of tones. And where you get excess polish on your nail, then just wipe it off. See how the page looks now. It's so pretty. So this is how it looks after all the dry brushing. Now, I got these new babies for my birthday from my college friends, and I'm so excited about trying these out. We'll make a complete video about it later sometime. Yeah, I'm just in love with this. I'm gonna be using this baby because I wanted to try the. This is a dotting tool actually. I thought it will be easy to do stripes with it, and I guess I was very wrong because it took a lot of time and it could just scrape off the nail polish lying underneath. So still I was trying to convince myself that this can work. Then I immediately threw it off. Now I took another brush. You can see, I don't know what is this brush called. Striping brush. This worked really well. I loved how it turned out. You can also use a trimmed off nail polish brush or eyeliner applicator, anything that I used to do in the previous videos of mine. You can check them out. And I went for this pattern because I really liked it. And finally, seal your design with a top coat, clear top coat. And don't forget to seal the edge of the nails. So this is how it looks. If you like this video, don't forget to give this video a thumbs up and subscribe for more such videos. Yeah, thank you.